Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So through today's video, I'm going to walk you through a recently released feature called Customer Vendor Balance Netting. And I want to start with why Microsoft released this really powerful feature and what's the business requirement, how this can be helpful for your day-to-day operations. And then secondly, as usual, I'm going to walk you through step-by-step all the configuration points. And then finally, I'll do a live demo with both invoice creation from vendor and customer side so you can really see the end result of this balance netting feature. So without further ado, let's get started. Please don't hesitate to like and subscribe. That will really help me to grow this channel. Thank you so much for your support. All right. So first, let's talk about why. I'm currently this BC01 company, right? And I'm selling audio parts to Walmart. So Walmart is actually my customer. At the same time, as a company, I also need to purchase some office supplies. And that means I purchase from Walmart. So Walmart at the same time is also my vendor account. So that gives a dual role situation for Walmart, who serves both a vendor and customer for BC01 company. And let's say normally, if I don't have any netting process in place, what I'm going to do if I purchase items from Walmart and at the same time sells items to Walmart, that means I will have two separate balances for both AP and AR. I'll need to have AP invoices and manage the AP payments from the AP side, and at the same time manage the AR invoices, send it to Walmart, and then collect the payments from them as a customer, right? So that will really give you a lot of headache issuing paperwork, entering multiple transactions, maintaining two balances for both AP and AR, and also from reporting perspective, it's kind of hard to have a final point to understand, okay, what's the net situation for Walmart? And with this new feature, netting balances, it will really save you a lot of time by giving you this opportunity of netting out the balances before we move forward with the payment. So what does that mean? Now I'm having both AP invoices and AR invoices, right, for the items I purchased from Walmart and also the audio parts I sold to them. Instead of going to make payments on both sides, I'm actually going to net out the balances for AP and AR, so that will give me a net result. So let's say if I have more AP balances, then that means when I finish the netting process, I will still have a small portion of open AP, then I will only need to manage the AP outstanding balance and pay out to Walmart. That's it. And vice versa, right? So I hope this is clear and does make sense. And in short, netting out balances before managing any payments from both AP and AR side is a strategic approach to minimize your monetary exchanges, reducing some unnecessary payments or receipts. So now we have covered the business use case and scenario. Let's move on to talk about technical configuration points. So overall, we will need to do two configuration points. First one is we need to let the system know what's the customer and the vendor relationship, right? To do that, I will need to open up my customer account for Walmart. So I'm currently in accounts receivable, all customers, and I will pick my invoice account for this head office. Let me open it up. So from your customer master, I need to define the relationship and point this customer account to as relevant vendor accounts. And now you see under this section, miscellaneous details, you have this remittance and vendor account. This field is basically to create that link to your vendor on the AP side. And mainly we need this information to manage this netting process and also for the customer refund process that I'm certainly going to cover in future videos, right? So now I have assigned my vendor account, I can save it. So we have completed the first step. Second step, we need to create some rules for netting so that the system will understand, all right, now which balance I should look for and what's the criteria, how I should net the transactions. So to do that, the netting is actually located in the cash and bank management module. And then here you can see I have a whole section for netting. You have two ways to do netting. One is manual, one is automatic. So let's start with the manual, and then at the end of the video, I'm going to show you real quick on the automatic netting, so stay tuned. For manual netting, as I said, first we need to create a netting agreement. So basically that was, let's open up this netting agreement screen. So I have one already created, but I can walk you through to create a new one, right? Basically what happened is you need to hit new button and then give a name. Let's say this is netting demo, and at the same time you need to pick a journal name. I have already this netting created, but let me actually show you what this journal looks like. So clearly you need to give a journal name netting, and then the journal type, we need to select this customer and vendor netting. So this is used to post your AP and AR balance through this journal and impact your bridging account. We're going to have a look just in a second. And of course, as usual, you have to assign a voucher series. I will not detail too much on the voucher series, but overall, those are the key information you need. Once you create this journal name, let's go back and basically pick this netting journal in this agreement. And now you see we have account. This is your bridging account the system is going to use to bridge your AP and AR postings once we run that netting process. I'll show you later on through that demo. So first, let's assign this account. I have a netting bridging account already created. So I manually tap this account, and you can see I call this account bridging. All right, all good. So from here, we will continue to add the role that I mentioned, right? We need to define who is the customer and what's the corresponding vendor account so the system can search the balance exactly based on this criteria. So on the customer side, it's going to be Walmart head office, and then the vendor side is going to be my vendor account, Walmart as well. And you can define a start date and end date to make it effective. In my case, I can do 2023 or 2020. It doesn't matter. And then you can leave the two date blank. That means it will always be effective, right? And after that, you are all set. So you can save it and then basically activate it. And since I have already one created for Walmart, I'm not going to keep this demo one. So I will just delete this real quick. Let's focus on this Walmart one. So it's exactly the same information we just did previously. Okay, so now we complete this second step. Now we're ready to run the netting process. But actually before that demo, I want to make sure we do have balances for AP and AR. Otherwise, there's no transaction available for the system to find for your netting, right? So let's check out the transactions. Under accounts payable, I'm going to find my Walmart vendor account, and then let's check if there is balance and transactions. Okay, so I do have a new invoice created with 765. That's the open balance. I can actually create a new one real quick. So let's do a new invoice journal. And here I'll pick AP, go to lines. I'll pick my Walmart account and give an invoice date, invoice number, credit. Let's do 3000. Moving to the right side, I'll need to assign offset account. Let's use a miscellaneous one. All right, so now I can post it. All right, all good. Now let's move to the AR side. So let's say now I'm selling audio parts, or actually I will go with the free tax invoice just to save some time. So I will create a new free tax invoice for my head office. And I'll pick my revenue account. That's going to be for something. So other revenues and unit price. Let's do 670. Okay, and now I can post it as well. So that way we are sure we have both transactions, or we can call it open AP and AR balances for Walmart. So now we have transactions checked. Let's move on to run the actual process for that netting. So again, we need to go back to cash and bank management module, and under netting, we have created agreement, And now to run or to process that netting, we have to click here, customer and vendor balance netting. This is more like your workbench where you can track all the historical nettings results and create a new netting. So in my case, I'll create a new netting. And two sections, right? First section is all the open customer invoices. And the second section is showing you with all the open vendor invoices. Now, the first method I'm going to show you is the manual netting process. So that means you have to manually mark which customer open invoice should be matched with which vendor invoice, right? So straightforward. Let's say in my case, I want to net out this 900 customer balance and then mark selected. So you see the check mark here. And let's move on. Under the vendor side, I will do the first invoice 765. Again, mark selected. Now, we have picked the relevant transactions. Of course, you can select multiple transactions. And the next step is going to define a netting posting date. So I'm going to pick today's date. And you can also turn on this option, print netting advice. Then the system is going to generate a report, but you can also leave it here. And then once the netting is done, you can print that report afterwards. So I'll show you later on. So now let's post this. So very straightforward, basically picking all the open invoices you want to net. And now you see the system has posted journals. And this posting actually will impact our bridging account, which is defined previously under that netting agreement. I'll show you in a second. So now it's posted. So let's go back one. Again, here we can check the netting history. I want to check what has been netted. So clearly for this transaction, the system net out my customer balance with 900 and my vendor balance of 765. Okay, and then from here, what you can do is check the open details and also print netting advice. So let me print this advice so we can see the results. All right, there you go. So you see we have legal entities on the top and then netting advice, and it actually lists out all the customer invoices and the vendor invoices being netted out. Since my customer balance is 900 greater than my vendor balance, so that's why you see a remaining balance of 135 under my customer. So that means I'm going to collect this 135 from Walmart. All right, so I hope that makes sense. So now let me go back one, coming back to this kind of a history review page. From here, you can also check the open details. That gives you, again, more details and also created by who and what's the invoice number. I'm going to go back, and then you can also reverse the netting in case this is just by accident or you find any mistakes. Then you can run this process and choose a date and just post that reverse transaction. All right, and then before we move on, I do want to show you that posting. So that bridging account we previously defined, how that impacts the accounting side. So to check that, I can actually go back to my vendor account. So under accounts payable, all vendors, and we can check the Walmart vendor account, and let's open up all the transactions. So you see there's a new voucher being generated with net. So this is through the journal name and voucher series we defined for this number sequence. And then you have the dates, and you see the balance is moving 765 through that netting and currently giving a zero balance on this vendor account, right? And if you want to see the posting, you can check the voucher. And here it shows accounts payable versus this bridging account. Okay, so by now we have run the manual netting process end to end. Just to do a quick recap, what has happened from configuration point. Number one, we need to define the customer vendor association. Number two, we need to create a netting agreement before we run that manual process, right? And then step three, before we actually run that netting, we need to ensure there are transactions or open balances for both AP and AR. And then once you are done with that part, then we can just go to the netting kind of workbench, that netting screen, and then manually process netting, and after that you can check the posting, print netting advice, and even reverse the transaction if it's not done correctly. Okay, so this is about the manual netting. Before we end, I do want to quickly highlight the possibility to do automatic netting. So let me actually go back to cash and bank management. We have already seen there are multiple netting agreements that you can create from the previous step. And then netting rules are basically kind of a regroupment of all those agreements, which can be automatically processed by the system depending on the schedule we define, kind of the batch job, right? So first step, we will define the netting rules. And then secondly, this process automations will help you to define your batch job, the running frequency, at what time, right? And then you can also manually launch that automatic netting process. This may sound a little bit confusing, but let's have a look. First, the netting rules. Let me open it up. So you can create a new rule. This is for the automation, right? So let's see. I'll call it automation demo. And what you can do here is you see there's netting sequence. This is the criteria you're defining to let the system know how the system should find out the transactions by due date from the newest to the oldest, or by invoice balance from largest to smallest. So that way the system can run automatically to match your customer open invoices and the vendor open invoices by this order, right? And then you can also say, okay, for my netting agreements, if I have multiple netting agreements, I want to let the system run automatic netting only for selected ones or for all my netting agreements. And so far I'm going to keep selected. You can decide to include credit note and debit note here. Okay, so in my case, I'll do yes, and then netting agreement here. First, I will need to add agreement because currently I'm selecting a specific netting agreement here. So I'll do Walmart, and then netting criteria. You can continue to refine the criteria. Let's say the invoice currency, that should be from which value. In my case, that will be USD. Okay, and then we'll continue. You have other criteria like the like the vendor account and then the customer account. So vendor account is legal entity based, this vendor Walmart, and then I'll continue with customer account, and I will need to define who is the customer account. So that's going to be my Walmart head office. So now I'm all good. I can save it. Same thing, you can activate this netting rules. So this rule is going to be used by the automation. And from there, what I mean by manually launch this automation is you can go to automatic netting here and select your netting rules, right? And pick the posting date. You can also define invoice due date. And I highly recommend to turn on this option, preview before posting. Otherwise, the system is going to post it automatically. And now let's run it. So you can see it's basically the similar screen, but this is automations. So system automatically suggests those matching results based on the criteria I defined through that netting rules. So now it picks up all the available balances and trying to match those. And from there, you can post it or cancel it. You can see the invoice details, but this is just to show you the possibility of doing automation. So now let's cancel it. And also the last thing here, you see the process automations. This is really kind of the batch job definition screen where you can say, okay, I want to create a new process automation, and I can pick a schedule and by which date, run how many times, for example. And then once you have this part ready, you no longer need to manually generate this automatic netting. The system will pick it up through that batch job and give you that result for posting. All right, so I hope this makes sense. Again, if you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave a comment. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next episode.